Hey, Facebook fans in the Free Leads group. It's Fred, the submarine guy, coming to you. I wanted to give you this live Facebook that'll be here for quite a while, by the way, because I learned a really important thing the other day and today, and I realized many of you can't get out of your own way to figure out this marketing thing and how to be successful and that kind of thing. And what do I mean by you can't get out of your own way? You have this fear. And believe me, I've had it too. And as long as I've been doing this, I still have it sometimes. It's weird. But you have this fear that you don't want to put yourself out. You know, in the open, put yourself out in public, advertising your business, advertising your product, advertising your service, trying to build a list. Whatever you're doing, you're scared that people are going to think badly, negatively, he or she's stupid. You know, that kind of crap doesn't work, whatever kind of thing. And then maybe you're going to be embarrassed or whatever. You don't want your friends to see it or your family, but you know, that kind of thing. You got to get out of your own way. We all, for the most part, run legitimate businesses. We're all looking for more customers, for more distributors, for more followers, and that kind of thing to build up our businesses, to build our income. There's nothing wrong with that. Storefront people do this all the time. They put those guys out in the sign with the signs, the twirly signs, you know, on the side of the road kind of thing. You know, those guys are making like $5 an hour and they look like idiots. But the store is getting the benefit, okay? But by not watching the video or not commenting on the video or not giving a thumbs up on the video like I'm asking you to, you're really sabotaging your own efforts. Okay, now I know that sounds weird, and let me get to the end of this before you cut this off, because you really are sabotaging your own efforts. So here's a story. 48 hours ago, I made a comment on Mark Harbert's video. Mark is a top marketer in online, say, internet marketing kind of things. He's a top person in My Lead System Pro. And no, I'm not marketing My Lead System Pro, but he's also within those a top YouTube marketer. And that's one of the reasons I followed him, because YouTube is an important distribution channel to get our messages out there and our face out there so that people can know, like, and trust us more, right? So what I found out that Mark is doing, though, in addition to he gives a lot of free training, kind of like I do. You know, I give as much as I can to you for free, that I know that's working, for everybody. Mark does the same thing. But one of the things he's not saying on his videos, but he did, was this. When I commented on his video, you know, I made a fairly substantive comment. It wasn't a paragraph or anything, but it's like, "Hey, Mark, great points. I wish everybody had followed these. We'd all see a lot more success," or you know, something like that. Obviously, I had watched his video. I was commenting directly on the content of the video, you know, that kind of thing. But it wasn't like an essay or anything. And so here's what I learned. Mark did three things to my comment on his video. He liked it with a little thumbs up thing. He hearted it, whatever that means. He clicked a little heart icon, and he commented back on my comment on his YouTube video. He took the time, and this probably didn't take him 30 seconds, right? But he took the time to do three specific actions on my comment. Why would he do that? Well, I thought maybe it was just a fluke, and you know, he didn't get any good comments that day, so he wanted to highlight one. I don't know. So I tried it again today. Well, actually, it was late last night. Today, he did the same thing on this comment. It was a different video, right? He probably recognized my name by now because this is the second time, but he did the same thing. He gave it the thumbs up. He hit the little heart icon. I don't think we're in love or anything, but and then he commented, "Thanks very much, Fred," or something like that. Now, why would a top marketer on YouTube comment on a reader's comment? I'll tell you why. Because it gets him more juice on his video. It gets him more traction, more Facebook terms, edge rank. That's not what they call it on YouTube. But it gives his YouTube video more power, and therefore YouTube will send more traffic to it to get him more viewers, more readers, more signups, all that kind of stuff. So if Mark Harbert does this, don't you think we ought to adopt that process, that practice? I do. So now let's go back to get out of your own way. If you're too timid to push the thumbs up button, to hit the like button, to hit the heart, or write a comment on my video, you need to get out of your own way for two reasons. One, that helps me boost my video, which, hey, I'll admit, I like boosted videos, right? But here's the thing, is by commenting on the video, your YouTube channel gets linked in your name above your comment. So if you have a couple of comments that people start seeing and all of a sudden they go, hey, Tammy's got some really good comments here. Let's go see what's on her YouTube channel. Somebody could click on there and go to your site. Now that's not going to happen with one or two comments, right? But the more you do that, on my channel, on other people's channels that you follow, that kind of thing, the more chance you'll get to have some of their readers, some of my readers, go over to your channel. And even if you don't have anything on your channel now, it'll still be there, right? I'm not going to delete a comment. It'll still be there forever, maybe. so that when you do start getting videos and you know, you get your readership up and that kind of thing, and then somebody sees you, and then they can come over, they can watch your video, they can like your video, they could thumbs up it, they could comment on your videos, they could click on your links. There's all kinds of things they could do just because you commented on my video or because I commented on Mark Harbert's video, okay? So get out of your own way. Get out of the fear of looking stupid, getting no respect. I don't know why you have this fear. I do too. Sometimes I just think, God, you know, are people going to really like this, or am I going to look stupid? Hey, you know, at 64 years old, I'm over the time where I worry about people thinking and what I look like, or, you know, having an opinion about what I look like. I don't give a flip anymore, right? Sometimes I don't shave for 5 days. I think I look pretty good. Who cares? But anyway, I get back to get over your fear of making comments, watching the full video, evaluating the video and writing comments about it and that sort of thing, so that we can both learn, we can both get more traction on our videos, and you can start building up some backlinks to your soon-to-be YouTube channel where you're going to be talking to people, training people, and that kind of thing, and building up more traffic. So that's the lesson for today. I wanted to do a personal video on this one. You know, a lot of times I do videos over a PowerPoint, and you know, I'm down in this corner over here with the little headshot kind of thing. But I wanted to give you a more personal video on this one because I think it's really important. And the fact that I wasn't seeing a lot of people liking the videos, watching the videos, commenting on the videos, kind of I put two and two together, or three and three, or whatever it was, and said, hey, maybe if I sort of put a wrapper around all this for everybody, they'll kind of get it. Okay. why we're doing YouTube. There obviously is for the personal touch and the training aspect, but why are we asking for comments and likes and thumbs up? Well, those boost our videos, and then the comments can help boost your videos. That's the whole thing. We're laying the groundwork for you to start marketing with videos, even if you don't know how you're going to do it yet. Okay. By commenting, you might even find a mistake in my video, or you might find something you could recommend that I could do better, right? I'm open to all kind of comments. That I don't care what you tell me. You don't like it, I don't care. Give me a comment. But by getting in the habit of doing that, the other thing you'll learn is when you do your video, you won't feel bad about asking people to, where am I, to hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, hit the heart icon, and leave me a comment in the video, right? I say that, or I try to say that in almost every video I do. I should say it in every one, right? Because you always want people to like and comment and forward your videos. So by you getting in that habit, then when you start doing videos, you can start, it'll be a habit for you to follow, to ask people to do that. Okay. So I hope this has made sense. A little bit of, it's kind of a complicated concept, but if you realize I'm not just doing this for me, I'm doing this for you too, I think you can start to see the value in it, and maybe we can both get some benefit out of it. Anyway, I hope this has helped. I'll save this video and put it up. I think I'll probably put it in lesson one, but I'll put a comment down in the discussion for you to come back and watch this video and give us a thumbs up or a like on the video. That's all I got. Have a great evening. Bye-bye.